Ladies and gentlemen, and this is RommelTanker, and today I'm going to explain the different types of ammunition in World of Tanks Blitz. So, you'll see here in front of you, I have a like tractor I just purchased for this demonstration, and I'm now on the ammunition page. Now, there are four different types of ammunitions in the game that you need to be any level of concerned or knowledgeable in. There are certain tanks that fire special armor-piercing rounds that you can't get on other vehicles, such as the SU-100Y here. This fires a special premium AP that does more damage at the price of less penetration, and you can tell the difference by the pink indicator when loading the ammunition, and by the special and different coloration of the shell icon. So, let's begin. The first and most basic shell that you're going to use in the game is armor piercing, or AP. AP is the primary round of most tanks. There are obviously a couple of exceptions, but this is the shell that you should have the most of loaded in your tank, with some exceptions. The way to tell the difference between an armor-piercing round and most other shells is that they will have middling levels of penetration and will do generally higher damage than rounds such as APCR, and will do less damage than high explosive rounds. So keep that in mind. The next shell type is APCR, or armor-piercing composite rigid. These shells are differentiated by the black indicator and the black icon when you're loading ammunition. These have higher penetration than standard armor-piercing rounds, but most of the time, when it's a premium ammunition round, there are some exceptions. It will do less damage, as can be seen here. Premium APCR will cost you gold or credits depending on how you convert it. Here I've just converted it to being purchased for credits if I so chose, and now back to gold. This is to prevent any accidental gold purchases on your account, and also to save gold in case you want to use it later. The next shell is high explosive. High explosive can be differentiated by the orange icon when loading and the orange shell icon in the orange shell icon. These can also be differentiated by the very low penetration of the shells, as can be seen here, but higher damage. High explosive is a special round that you use when you need to deal extra damage to thinly armored targets, or alternatively, when you can't penetrate a target but still need to damage them somehow to, say, reset the capture circle. The fourth and final shell that you need to be any sort of concerned with is HEAT, High Explosive Anti-Tank. Now this is tier 8 heat, so it's going to have significantly higher penetration than, say, tier 2 heat. Heat is easily distinguished in-game by a gold tracer roughly the same color as this. It can also be distinguished in your garage by a gold icon and a very odd-shaped shell. Heat is very unreliable in some ways, in that it cannot penetrate spaced armor, such as these track plates on the like tractor. If they were thicker and on a higher tier tank, that is, on the like tractor, it doesn't matter. It has a hard time penetrating sloped armor at angles, say, like this. This is because heat has no normalization, which is a mechanic that I may explain later on if I find the time and the drive to do so. Now, I was saying that there are exceptions to what tanks fire APCR and heat in what shape or form. An example is this tank, the Leopard 1. I obviously haven't researched it yet, but I'm grinding for it. The Leopard 1 fires armor-piercing composite rigid, or APCR, as its standard ammunition, and it fires heat as its premium ammo. This is because this is what is commonly referred to as a main battle tank. It's also a tier 10 medium, which is another factor as to why it fires APCR standard. There's currently two tier 10 mediums in the game that do not fire APCR standard. The Object 140, and no, not the STB one. The Object 140 and the WZ-121. Now, I have no clue why they don't fire APCR standard, but I assume it had something to do with realistically the APCR shells would not have gone in the gun. Of course, the Object 140 recently had its APCR removed. Anyways, that's all for today. Let me know what you think.